Hey guys, it's Boder. This is really embarrassing, but the first half of the video that you're about to watch is out of focus. I set the camera and the audio and the GoPro over here. Hi GoPro. But I forgot to set the focus, and it's like out here somewhere. I'm zoomed out all the way, so I hope it's not too bad, but there's no way that I could redo the parts of the video going over what I got for this build and everything like that. So, sorry. Please bear with me. And hopefully by using the GoPro angle a lot more than this one, we're still able to get something useful out of it, because I feel that it's a useful video for putting together the Commodore 64X Barebones, which aside from a couple tiny little issues that I'm going to mention at the end of the video when I'm back to wearing this again, is complete, boots up, everything like that. So guys, enjoy. And sorry. Hello everyone. In the first video of this series that is kind of spread across different series, unboxes something and vlogs and stuff. In the first video, I unboxed the Commodore 64 Barebones. In the second video, I cleared out our craft room and built the table, all with the help of Steph. I didn't do it myself. But got the table built, and now it is time to put together the Commodore. I'm going to show the components that I've got to go into it, tell you a couple things that are still kind of missing from it, and then I hope that it's just going to be a time lapse straight to the end. If there is something interesting that happens during the build, then that means that something went wrong. First off, obviously, there is the Commodore case. Put that over there. The heart of that is an ASRock J3160 DC ITX. This is a mini ITX motherboard. It has the processor and GPU built into it, so it's kind of an all-in-one, and does come with its own external power supply, so there's less room taken up inside the case. Because it's a proprietary power supply that goes in, it has custom cords for SATA, and I think it only has two of them, but that's okay because I'm only going to need two, one for the hard drive and one for the optical drive. It was something that I put a lot of research into. People will go with other ASRock ones that are all-in-one, but this is what I end up going with. By the way, all of these components I am going to put links to in the description below. I would do a single list on PC Part Picker, except that some of these are not on PC Part Picker. I would do a single like Amazon list sort of thing, except that some of these are not on Amazon. And I would do a single Newegg list, except, well, fill in the blank. The one thing that is not kind of included on that motherboard that potentially could be is RAM. So I just have an 8GB stick of Corsair Vengeance RAM. 8 should be enough, but if I need to get more, then I'll get another 8GB stick. The motherboard can handle up to 16GB of memory. For storage, I mentioned optical drive and hard drive. The hard drive is a laptop-sized Western Digital Blue, 500GB. It is a hard drive, not a solid state, because solid state is more expensive, and I don't see this really needing to move around, and it doesn't need to be super speedy. All it's really going to be for is internet browsing and some streaming, so that's fine. I think I probably could have gotten a full-size 3.5-inch now that I think about it, but everybody was talking about solid-state mounted in this thing, so I was just in the 2.5-inch form factor mindset, but a hard drive. Optical drive is a, I believe, an LG Slim. It was like $25 on Amazon. It was the cheapest one I could find. It is a DVD writer as well, yes. DVD burner. It's not Blu-ray, but I don't need Blu-ray. All it needs to do is read a Windows 7 install disk, which I have, and which is later on in the list. In order to mount those in the case, this specific bracket is needed. Others might work, but this is the one that everyone says that they use and that works. When they say bare bones, they mean bare bones. It would be nice if this had a bracket built into it. That would be, yes, this is the shelf that the DVD drive sits on, and then underneath that is the where you put your hard drive, but no, it all kind of, you've got to get it piecemeal. So this is the bracket that everyone suggests. It's a Bitech 5.25-inch metal tray for HDD Slim, DVD, HD, slim DVD, a bunch of different ways that they can all kind of mount together, but that's that. And then we just kind of, counting down to like the smaller things, there's a spot for a 40-inch fan in back, so I got a Noctua fan, which this is like super, super fancy packaging for what is a 40mm fan. But it's a nice looking one. I like the color of it. Hopefully that's not getting glare for that camera. I mean, it kind of matches that and all and high end, and hopefully it'll do what I want. It was more expensive than other 40mm fans, but not disgustingly so. We'll get to disgustingly expensive in a sec, not to mention how this. Anyway, obviously I don't need a keyboard for it, which I had to keep reminding myself while I was picking up pieces, because it's built in. I did get a Corsair Saber gaming mouse. I don't need a gaming mouse, but I like the look of them. They're fancy. And this is a older revision with a previous Corsair gaming logo. So it was on sale and should feel nice. I always go Logitech with mice, but I couldn't justify spending like double the price just for a free spinning mouse wheel. And then because a streaming computer doesn't do much if it can't connect to the internet, a Netis AC1200 USB internet adapter. And then finally, almost finally, penultimately, a 23-inch Asus widescreen monitor that has speakers built in, so less stuff on the desk, which is great. I noticed it. It was pretty. I sent it to Steph. She said, oh, it also doesn't have, it also has speakers built in. I was like, sweet. Just shove that back there. And then finally, Windows 7. I have a three-copy family pack of Windows 7 Home Premium Upgrade, but it is possible to do a clean install with the upgrade version. We already have two licenses on the main computers in the other room, so this will just be the third license used. So, all that being said, time to start going in at this stuff. The first thing I'm going to do is actually open up the monitor, because this is a big box. I'm going to put the monitor in place, get a sense of where it is. And it's an easy way to be like, oh, look, something has been achieved. The monitor is already up. And then from there, I'm just going to open up the case, attach the motherboard, and just put the bracket in, and just kind of take it piece by piece. So we're going to clear off some of this and get to work. The monitor came with VGA cables, not DVI or HDMI. So let's toss that back in there. I did get a spare HDMI cable for it. Plastic stuff if you didn't do these random glossy, everything matte. Fortunately, the screen is matte and looks gorgeous. It is frameless, more or less. When the screen is on, there will be a bit of a frame apparent, but while it's off, it is gorgeous looking. So can't wait to pull off this little piece of plastic that somehow got stuck on the edge right here and get this all assembled. There we go. I should get a surge protector for this. I have an outlet right here, one for the computer, one for the monitor, but eventually we're going to need one for a hot glue gun and for iron for pearly beading. So a surge protector is on the to-buy list, something that I do need to get. Not necessary for the computer, but for what I'm planning on doing with it. So next we're opening up the case. I did, in the intervening time, make a small embellishment. And everyone's like, oh my god, what did you do? The full extreme or whatever came with a card reader on the right side. And I looked at different card readers, and in order to install one, styrofoam is loud. In order to install a card reader, You wouldn't be able to do it intact because it goes right over the motherboard. You wouldn't be able to have the casing on it. You have to like pull the circuit board and the ports out. So what I did, I just got a cover for a 3.5 inch bay that I had from one of our PCs, either my previous AMD Thermaltake one or my current Thermaltake level 10. I'm honestly not sure which that came from, but it looks nice. It's got vents and some foam, so it allows for airflow, but keeps dirt from getting in, and I am happy. So, case. And I'll just pull this right off. There we go. And we're gonna work in the bottom first. We're gonna get the motherboard installed. I need a screwdriver. Grab my screwdriver, and I also have a ton of screws. I have a bag of screws and zip ties from another case install. Also some motherboard standoffs, which are nice, but not needed for this installation, I hope, because there's only three in there and I would need four if it came to that. But no, it looks like the standoffs are built into the plastic right here, so that's fine. But yeah, the case doesn't come with anything. It doesn't come with screws or anything like that. So it's all what you've got lying around. Fortunately, I have a whole bunch of these computer installation screws. And there's probably some in the motherboard box as well. So we're gonna open this up, take a peek. I'm gonna see what I have in here really quick. Then we'll get back to the music, whose title I forget, but I can put in the description if I remember. We've got the back for the motherboard, or the shield, or whatever you wanna call it. Got a driver disk. I saw some sort of note about this not being super friendly with Windows 7 64-bit, like you just gotta install some extra stuff, but I'll worry about that afterward. I know how to install the hardware at least. SATA cable. Custom SATA power header, I think. Tiny, tiny screw. Okay, what's that for? Package contents. Support CD, data cables, power adapter, panel shield. Wi-Fi module screw. Well, considering there's not a Wi-Fi module in the box, and I got a USB Wi-Fi adapter, I'm not going to need to worry about the tiny, tiny screw. If only one module is installed, please install the DDR3A1. Are they labeled on the board? Yes, they are. Good. So the one closest to the edge of the board is what we've got for RAM right here. And it looks like they just slide in like that. Of course, I don't have a knife down here. I had one on my keys, but I flew last week, and I'm flying again next week, so no sense in putting a knife on my keys. Okay, got our Corsair Vengeance RAM. Hopefully that's the side that faces up. Yes, it is. All right, so the side closer to the edge. Oh, we're covering up the ASRock logo and the motherboard name. It looks like it can kind of go in like this, and then you just pop it down. Yeah, there we go. So in like that. There we go, now that clicks in. So RAM is installed. So we're gonna take this, just kind of move it over like that. And that's where that's gonna be. Okay, I do stand corrected. There are a few screws in a pouch. Emblem. Warranty void if removed sticker, which is absolutely going on there when this build is finished. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 little stubby ones. So these are probably our motherboard mounting screws. And then I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then there's two over here that are for mounting the flash drive. But it looks like all of these are the same size, so I don't have to worry about mixing those up. So yes, we're gonna use these four to install the motherboard right here. I'm glad that I was mistaken about screws not being included, because how would you put the case together if you didn't have the right screws? You just kind of got to guess. It's no fun.
Mm-hmm.
have a bunch of little screws included here, so we for mounting hard drive, solid state. Great. And when I drop this in here, oh, plastic, just random plastic on the edge to come off. Great. Right? Yeah. Oh, wow. This is completely covered in a sheet of plastic. This isn't even something that I'm worried about, like, getting fingerprints on, so I don't know why the plastic covering over every single edge. So dropping it in here, it does look like our four holes there do indeed keep this in place. Oh, whoa. Oh, it just drops right in. There's a little inset right here that this fits right into. That's stellar. It's not perfect alignment. Does this need to come off? This might need to come off. The front plate is meant to take a full-size drive bay and then mount a slim drive in here instead. Notice that there's vents for cooling in front there. And then also be able to mount a hard drive. So it's for very efficient use of a full 5.25 drive bay. Drive 5.25. Thank you, camera, for cutting off as I was tripping over my words. That was, you're a bro. Anyway, it's meant for a thing that is not this. So I'm pulling off extra screws, put them in another thingy there. Oh no, I need to attach the hard drive first, and then I can screw this down into there. Actually, I'm looking at that. A 3.5 would fit, but man, that would be rough. Oh, right, duh, a 3.5 would mount from the side. So this goes down, and then 3.5. It'll work, whatever you do, just there's methods to the madness. Feet on the bottom? No, but it should, so I will probably get those. Okay, bracket is installed. The disk drive sits back a little bit. It's a little recessed, but that's just because of the bracket. If it could have been moved forward a little bit, that would have been nice, but I think I'm going to be happy with it as is. We attach the slim drive, 2 points there, and then 2 points kind of under the shelf here. I needed to go grab another screwdriver. Yes, it is a Luke Skywalker lightsaber, be jelly. And one of them didn't go in for some reason. I don't know if it's a different thread size on that screw. There's like two different size screws in the pouch or something. I don't know. But they're in, and that is done. So, next step, we're going to hook up some cables. That's going to be power and data going to our two drives there. Hold on, let's see. So, looks like we can power two things at once. What's going on there? There's this. So SATA is this bigger one for power, and then a smaller one for data. But the slim drive looks like it has not the same thing going on. It's got a small one for data right there. And that is going to be rough because I do not have that cable and it didn't come with that cable, correct? No, it didn't. It needs a different cable than I've ever seen in my life and it didn't come with it. So, that means that I will not be completing this build today. Shit. Yeah, I did not know that slim DVD burners in general need a smaller SATA cable. And I do not have one of those. So I will hook up the rest. I will not be securing the case quite yet. I was hoping to do that, but that's fine. I'm still waiting on another piece as well. That is still disappointing. Okay, so I mentioned before that it would only have power for two devices. It does have only two headers there, but each one comes out into two cords like this. So you can still power four SATA devices, which is good because there are four SATA ports on here. Again, though, I am going to have to figure out the slim SATA on the slim DVD. So I just realized I've probably been out of focus for this entire time. Power is a pain because the drive is mounted directly against the bottom there. And it's really hard to get that power in there like that. Maybe if I can twist the cables off to the side a little bit. I feel like motherboard standoffs would be a really good thing to use for the hard drive in here because the problem I'm running into is that there is simply not enough room for the bottom of my power cable here against the bottom of the case. I might have to pull that whole assembly apart just to get this on. Oh, nope, there we go. That just went in, and that's not coming out. Like it could if I wanted it to, but I don't ever want it to. Okay, so here's what I've done. I do not have the disk drive hooked up. What I merely want to do is see if this will boot. I have a power lead and a reset lead, or a power lead and an LED lead. I don't know. They're not labeled, and I have no way of figuring out which is which. So I've plugged one into power and one into LED. And we're gonna see what happens. I might have to flip them, I might have to switch them. One might be reset, I don't know. So I'm gonna get power hooked up and I'm gonna get the monitor hooked up and we're gonna see if we can get this thing to boot into BIOS. I am getting a red light on here. I don't know if that's good or if that's bad. Waiting for monitor to be on. I realize I also don't have a speaker for this. I think the motherboard has a spot for a speaker, but that's just for a beep beep or whatever. Can I hit the button and see what happens? Nothing. Nothing. Okay. Unplugging power. We're going to swap those two. Actually, you know what? I'm not even going to worry about the LED. That looked like it was the LED, though. Oh, no, because I already pulled the power. Herp derp. So now we have one on power, one on LED. Plugging in. Power. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Light goes on. I heard the hard drive kick on. All right. Reboot and select proper boot device or insert boot media and press a key. We've booted. We have a proper setup. Okay, so what that means is that the white jumper or whatever right here, the white plug, that is our LED that shows system status. The blue one is power. There's nothing hooked up to reset, so that simply turns it off. If I hit that button again, it simply turns off the machine. It is not going to be used for a reset. Without getting the disk drive hooked up, I think that's almost all I can do. However, I do want to get this fan installed. So let's do that. And then I think we're going to call that a day. And next time, I will get the cable for... Oh, my. That's intense. So this has like four plastic things to attach. It's also got screws if you want to use that. I think this is just going to sit in there. Yeah, because I do not see screw attachments. So for now, I'm just going to kind of drop it in. Jesus. Thanks, Dave, for the birthday wishes. I'm just going to drop this in, make sure that it powers on. Which way does airflow go? That way? All right, cool. So this is an exhaust fan. It's going to go out like that. Got enough for this to come out and try to figure out where a fan lead on the motherboard is. Oh my God, if there is one. Fan one, there we go. Okay, and we're going to hit power again. And that little fan is doing some work. So my next step is I'm getting a fan grill in on Thursday. That's going to go in front right here. I might need to have something extra for spacing. This doesn't look like it's actually going to secure, so all we'll be doing is just putting in stuff just to make sure that it is snug. It's not going to secure with the snaps or the screws or anything like that. All right, so actually there is a change that I want to make. I took out the black SATA cables from the last time, and I've got a couple colored ones here. The black ones were SATA 3, giving 6 gigabyte a second transfer speeds. These are only SATA 2, giving only 3 gigabyte a second, but that's fine because they have the right angle attachment, meaning they're not going to pop up off the motherboard, making it a lot easier to get them into place without taking up a lot of space within the case. Yeah, I'm already liking how this is looking. So there's going to be a little bit of cable management going on here, but this is going to make for a much more easily closing case when all is said and done. There we go. And that is taking up a lot less vertical space, and that makes me pretty happy. Obviously, everything is still a little pell-mell, but if I take this now and go to drop it on top, I can much more easily see how that's going to close once these other cables aren't popping out the back here. And the fan and the everything. Yeah, that'll close nicely. Hello! It is now Tuesday. That's me. That's me. You're not used to voices coming from in here, Ronan. He's not used to voices coming from this room. It's now Tuesday. It's a couple days after my birthday. enough time for this to come in from Amazon. This is an adapter for regular SATA cables over to mini SATA. The regular cables plug in here. Mini SATA here to plug into the disk drive. So we're going to get this all plugged in, and then I might be able to get an operating system installed. I'm still waiting on a fan grill for the back, so I kind of don't feel like securing it all together, but I am just going to do a little bit of zip tying and see if I can get things secured together and just kind of set it in place. So here we go. There's really no assistance inside the case for cable routing. So this enormously long power and LED lead is just going to kind of flop along the top of the motherboard. Now the heat sink on the CPU is fanless, so I don't have to worry about cables getting caught. In fact, the only fan in here is the one that is the 40 millimeter one that I installed at the back. But it still weirds me out that I've got this much cable that's just going to kind of sit here and it's going to just rest on the board. Okay, we're closing it up now. Cable is tucked inside. Let me get that off of the heat sink just because that's probably height that we can't afford. That cable tie is plastic, so I don't have to worry about anything being conductive. And can tighten up just a few more notches. There we go. Actually, if I slip it loose, it might be able to just sit on the board right there. If it sits on the heat sink, that's extra height, but I think we're good right there. We're going to see how that goes. Going to drop this in here. And this is going to be careful all the way around because we have to make sure that all cables are tucked in. I've got to get my fan tucked in the back. I've got to get the I.O. shield. Oh, I should unplug power while I'm doing this. I've got the I.O. shield for the motherboard on the back as well. Oh, yeah, someone was mentioning that that fan might not fit right. Hold on. Good, good. Going all the way around, we're going to tuck that inside. How's that? That feels better. Do that. Good. How's the fan looking? The fan actually isn't doing bad. Yeah. Guys, it's closed. And as screws tighten up, yeah, so there was, someone else was saying that they had problems fitting a fan in, and they had to file away a little bit of the case. That does not need to happen with this fan. I did notice today while I was looking through some of the build thread stuff that some people have drilled their own holes in the bracket on the side here, because you notice that the DVD drive doesn't pop all the way out. However, it still has clearance for the door to open. It's just an aesthetic thing that it doesn't sit flush. Steph is watching John Oliver. This front corner didn't close quite right, and I don't know if there's something in the way. This cable on this side, the SATA cables keep trying to peek out on the front left corner. And on this one, I think that, no, that's not it. This front corner isn't quite closing up. I'm not sure. Oh, there we go. I just needed to push it around a little bit. There. That is closed. Again, I'm not going to seal it up because I'm going to be putting a fan grill on the back, but it doesn't look bad as is. But I paid way too much for the fan grill coming in. I'm going to talk about that when that comes in. But tonight, let's see if we can get an operating system installed here. So I'm going to plug in the monitor right there. I'm going to plug in power right there. Ah, caps lock was on. Caps lock is on. I got blinded by that caps lock light that you see on my hand. Huh. Why is caps lock on? There we go. That was bizarre. Nothing going on. When I turn that off, does caps lock come back on? No? Okay, it was a fluke. Let's get the mouse out. I don't have a mouse pad right here, right now. But on the tabletop should be fine for now, as long as I don't keep to using that and kind of wear down the table, because that can happen. So first we're going to pop a disc in here. Turn that on. Let's see here. Ooh. Maybe we will need to adjust that to get that to sit right. Getting some grinding noise in there. Okay. So I might need to move that forward because the case was keeping the tray from opening. This is 64-bit. Oh, crap. There was something I needed to do for 64-bit, wasn't there? Whatever. We'll give it a shot. Yeah, so if I get this out of here, it goes just fine. But the case is just too thick for it. The bracket is in just the wrong position. So people did mention redrilling. I'm a little hesitant to do that, but I may have to. So for now, we'll do this. That disc can stay in there. But long term, I'm going to need to figure something out there. Anything from the mouse? No mouse? Okay. Okay, that's an issue. So the keyboard was not detected. Okay, now we got mouse. I've got some lights on my mouse, so maybe that'll be detected for use in the CD booting. And the mouse lights just went off. Okay, so we might have to muck around in BIOS just for the keyboard to be detected. There we go. Okay, so F2. Function F2 worked. Alright, I'm gonna have to figure this one out, guys. So in trying to get the keyboard to be detected, I went into the BIOS and disabled legacy USB support because it was something that some people recommended. I have since been unable to use anything, keyboard or mouse. I haven't been able to get to the BIOS to switch it back. I have another keyboard that's a standard or relatively standard layout, and that's not being detected. I have pulled the battery out of the motherboard in an attempt to reset the CMOS on it. And I will be looking into other things that I can do. Back at my desktop instead of trying to browse on my phone. So I'll let that sit out and hopefully we'll reset by the time I get back to it. You might be better off installing Windows on the drive that you intend to use, using another computer with more standard components and keyboard and all that, and then swapping the drive over. But man, it's going to be a pain in the ass to pull that drive, so I really don't want to do that. We'll see. Okay, so I have completely cleared the CMOS. I pulled the battery, and I'm able to use jumpers. I was able to use jumpers to clear the CMOS as well. So I'm now presented with copyright American Megatrends, BIOS date 3/31/2016, CMOS date time not set, delete to run setup, sure. USB configuration does show legacy USB support enabled. Good. Everything else I'm not going to try to touch. I've brought over another keyboard and try to use that, which wasn't working before with legacy USB turned off, so who knows. How do I set the time? Because it's not Thursday, the 31st of March anymore. Yeah, I don't see how to set the time on it, so we're just going to go into save changes and exit. And see what happens. Hopefully it's just a keyboard layout thing it's not detecting here. And not just completely killing keyboard support. Keeping an eye on my light on top of the keyboard. If that goes out, then I'm screwed. I'm screwed. So my next step is unplugging this keyboard from the USB header on the motherboard and trying to only use the other one. Mouse went out, keyboard went out. Come on! I know what might be the problem, actually. I was talking about needing stuff for the 64-bit install of Windows, and this might be the thing. If I tried installing 32 on here, it'd probably be okay. But 64 with this motherboard might be an issue, so I'm going to look into what that is and see what the hell I need to do for that. Might be a BIOS update or something. Yes, okay, so here's what has to happen. I need to take... Oh, excuse me. Disk, I need you. I need to take... This disk, excuse me, I need to take this disk over to my other computer and use software that is on the driver disk in here, right there. I need to take these two and make a Windows 7 install disk that has the proper drivers for keyboard. Okay, it is now after midnight, meaning it is technically Wednesday, and I have a burned DVD here that should be an updated Windows 7 install with the proper USB drivers on it. So I'm gonna plug the Commodore's keyboard back in, and we'll be optimistic and give this a proper close up. Just tuck everything in. Oh, why do I do this to myself? I'm flying for work tomorrow and I'm getting in at midnight central time instead of Eastern, which means 1 a.m. my clock time, and then the next day I'm coming back and I'm getting in at midnight, and then I have a wedding shoot on Saturday, and it's like the busiest month, and I'm trying to do this, and I'm trying to do St. Jude Play Live, and okay, nice stuff to talk about while getting that all set, but now we stop complaining. And we pop in the disk. I'm gonna press a key. And we're gonna see how it goes. I've still got the other keyboard plugged in over here, but obviously if I can avoid it, I'd like to use this as much as possible. It's kind of the idea. Yeah, I'll worry about getting it properly close afterwards. Also, I think instead of filing the case, I'm going to file off a little bit of a tab of the DVD drive. I think that'd be better than chipping away at the case itself. That just feels mean and wrong somehow. Ooh. Ooh. Okay. I mean, oh, see, the keyboard is on and caps lock works, but I guess it's looking for the mouse here. Aha! Mouse, language to install English, time and currency format, English, keyboard input method, US? Question mark? We're going to go with US. And install. What to know before installing Windows? Install now. Setup is starting. So I have a upgrade license of this, but frankly, it can be used for a clean install anyway. So, sorry, Microsoft. It's not like you're selling Windows 7 anymore anyway. I accept these license terms, he says, not reading them. What kind do you want to do? Custom, install a new copy of Windows. Does not keep your files, settings, or programs. Well, good, it's tabula rasa anyway. And now we wait. But, things are looking promising. And, tonight we're going to go as far as having this operating system installed. Probably editing this on Sunday at this point. Oh! Because with a wedding shoot on Saturday, I need to make sure I get a decent amount of sleep the night before. So, Friday night, Friday night's probably not a working night for me. Oh, this entire week made invalid for streaming for St. Jude Play Live. Even though this is coming out next week, I'm going to talk to you guys about that. I'm doing streaming online. This is actually meant to be a streaming machine. Hopefully we'll be up and running next week when this goes up. But I've been streaming for St. Jude Play Live, which is mostly for gaming and gamers to try to raise money for St. Jude Children's Hospital. St. Jude is run entirely by donations. The average donation is $38. No, $33. And that can be mega donors all the way down to someone donating a dollar, $2 and saying, I guess I'm not getting coffee today. I'm going to help out the kids at St. Jude. Nobody who gets treatment there pays a cent. It's all paid for by donations to the tune of like $2 million a day. Yes, I know the American medical system is screwed up and that it comes to that, but it's a fantastic, fantastic cause. And it's not just straight-up medical bills, either. They'll pay transportation to get family to visit. There's one story that Panzer shared where it was a mom and a daughter, and the daughter had to get treatment at St. Jude. And the mom was going to... They were going to take care of getting her to Tennessee, making sure that she had a place to stay, and boarding their dog so that they wouldn't have to give up their dog while they were going through treatment. They care about the kids and their families. And I think it's fantastic. So if you want to give, there's a link in the description below. It is tiltify.com/events/BoterBugXPlayLive. That's BoterBugXPlayLive. So check that out and give if you can. That link, by the way, is up until the end of May, May 31st, 2017. If you're watching this video after that, then keep your eye out for, well, I mean, donate to St. Jude anyway, by all means. It doesn't have to be through my vanity link. Sorry, this is a really long episode, guys. I kind of get talking, and at this point, I'm overtired, and I don't know if this will make it into the video. Oh, thanks. GoPro couldn't do it anymore. I should probably turn that camera off before I'm tempted to keep talking to it and making this video even longer. Starting Windows. The install process was long and boring and automated. I am tired, but rather excited. Tire-sighted. Excited. Oh, let's see here. Choose a username for your account. That is obviously going to be Boater. Type a computer name. I'm just going to call it Commodore. Tab and everything is working just fine. Type your username. Crafty Boater. Boater at Crafts. Bead Boater. Boater. Username Boater. The computer name is Commodore. Could be Craft Commodore, Craft Computer, whatever. Type a password. This password's going to change because you can see my typey. So we are going to call it Craft Table. Craft Table. And the password hint is Craft Table. Because security. I'm changing that afterward. We're just going to skip activation right now because it's an upgrade one, and I guess you got to do that from in Windows. Help protect, improve Windows automatically. Security updates and other important updates. Now we're going with Eastern time. And it's going off the BIOS clock, so we got to switch that right now. May, of course, it's the 10th now. 136. No, not quite. It's late, but not that late. 1246. That looks like that'll do it. Once we get to the desktop, I'm considering it done. Off camera, I'm going to, I'll worry about that when I get more stuff. I'll show you guys the fan grill before it goes in, as well as closing everything up, but then I'm not going to bother showing you installing drivers for the GPU, so I get proper resolution on here and everything like that. This must be really thrilling to watch because I'm about to just keel over and nod off, and that's something I just don't do. So, hey, look at that! We have a desktop! Cool, guys! I have a fully functioning Windows 7 PC here, built within a Commodore 64 case. This is cool. I just want to open up Notepad. This is how high the hands sit here. This feels kind of odd, but it's awesome. It feels good. I am gratified that this build is, for all intents and purposes, complete. I'm putting in the fan grill. I'm going to screw it all closed with the screws that are right here. I put them inside the little RAM plastic thing so they wouldn't go anywhere, but then I almost forgot where they were, so that... planning. And then I got the two webcams in for streaming, and I'm getting an arm to mount the webcams on either today, Wednesday, or Thursday, aka while I'm gone. But this should be up and streaming next week. Hello everyone, I'm back again. I thought that this would go on the next video, but considering I haven't even moved the cameras from the previous video except to charge the GoPro back up, which I did about 10 minutes ago, so I have no idea how long it'll last. I guess that's going at the end of this video. I have no idea how this is going to look in the editing room. It might be smooth, or it might have more endings than Return of the King. Or Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2. Anyway, the last couple things to finish off the build, I want to go over these really quick right now. I ordered this 3D printed fan grill from user CoreI64. He has a 3D printing shop, has a bunch of Commodore paraphernalia type stuff, cool stuff. And this particular one is a fan grill that's specifically sized for the 64X. If you have a standard size fan right here, what we can do is just take this, put it together like that, and just drop it right in. I don't want to move this too much because I already have everything zip tied inside there. But it just drops right in, just like that. It's a perfect fit. It's not a perfect color match. This is the beige color. You could get it in black, orange, blue, white, whatever. It's not a perfect color match, and it was $30. It was like $8 plus 22 shipping to the United States or something like that. I overpaid. And this is... Forum user CoreI64. I love that you've made this. It's well made, everything like that. That shipping is for that, it's like astronomical. I wish I had a 3D printer, whatever. That would cost more to get that. Overpaying is kind of the theme for this build. The case potentially overpaid for, but it's the idea. I would recommend, unless you really, number one, unless you can color match a bit better with the color of the case, get it in black. Or like if you really, really, really want to get it so that it looks authentic, go for it. Otherwise, I would say get like a $3 Fangirl off of Newegg and, excuse me, I just realized that my voice is a little bit deeper because I just woke up. Get like get a $3 Fangirl off of Newegg and figure out the spacing on your own. Anyway, so that's that. Now that that's in, everything is done. I have the speaker cord going from the motherboard out to the monitor. I've got the little Commodore badge on the monitor. I am going to trim down the DVD tray right here. I'm not quite sure what I'll use, and whatever I do use, people are going to yell at me for it, so I'm not going to show that on camera. Probably just something to like snip a little bit and then just a file to round it back out. I've got my Wi-Fi adapter over here that I'll be plugging in and getting that all set. But I will be streaming this Sunday. I hope to have this video up before then, and certainly the follow-up one, but I've got the equipment that I need for that. I've got two Logitech C16 webcams. This is what I have on my computer in the other room, and it works fantastically. I was going to upgrade that one and move it back, but this has like the swivel head that makes it really versatile. So I've got two of those, one for the face cam and one for looking down on perler bead stuff while I'm working on it, because this keyboard is going to be like over here. And I have a generic microphone recording stand that's just going to hold the other one up over what's being worked on. Professional recording microphone series. Listed on Amazon as desk clamp, mount suspension, boom, scissor arm, tripod stand holder for Logitech webcam, C922, C930, C930, C920, C615, white. Also available in black, blue, and I think pink. I'll link to it. So I went white just because of the color of the table. But anyway, that's me going for way too long and probably like a 2-hour video or something. I have no idea. I need to edit this tonight. So guys, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. I stumbled my way through this build. Some parts I was more confident than others. That Windows 7 install can go... Let me know what you think of the case, of the build, of everything kind of put together. You can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.com/... Oh, obviously I'm going to close this up with, you know, using the screws right here that I set aside. And it's going to be all closed up and pretty. And that's after I deal with the DVD case and get that all trimmed down. You can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.com/boaterbug and support me on Patreon.com/boaterbug. You can subscribe down below and watch me live at twitch.tv/boaterbug to see me using this on Sunday and on other days besides. So guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a good one, and I will see you next time.